Hello, and welcome to today's math tutorial on how do you add fractions when the denominators are not the same. Let's take a look at our math task and see if we can figure out how we're going to join these fractions with unlike denominators. So it says the fourth grade classes are creating a mural for the school hallway. Mrs. Couples' class painted 6/10 of the mural during Monday's art class, and Mrs. Bond's class painted 22/100 of the mural during Tuesday's art class. What part of the mural is painted? Well, I know what part of the mural means. I need to add these two fractions together, but I also know I haven't learned how to add fractions with unlike denominators. So if I go into the problem and I take a look at this 6/10 and this 22/100, those are unlike denominator fractions, right? And I know I want to add them together because it says what part of the mural is painted. So I look at 6/10 and I'm going to add 6/10 to 22/100. And I'm going to use what I know about equivalent fractions to help me do this. So I know these two denominators are different, and when I add fractions, I don't add denominators. I only add the numerators. But I can take this fraction, which is tenths, and make it an equivalent fraction to hundredths. So I know that 10 times 10 is 100. So if I multiply the denominator by 10 to get it to 100, I have to multiply the numerator by 10 because whatever I do to the denominator, I also have to do to the numerator to keep it an equivalent fraction. And 6 times 10 is 60 hundredths. Sorry, that's hundredths, not tenths, right? So now I know that 6/10 is equivalent to 60 hundredths. And I now have a way of adding my two fractions together because I can add hundredths plus hundredths. I know the denominator is going to stay the same. It's going to stay hundredths. And then I just add the numerator, and 60 plus 22 is 82. So now I know that the part of the mural that's painted is 82 1/100. See how tricky that was? Just change one of the denominators into an equivalent fraction so that you can add the two parts together. So let's take a look at this practice problem. We have 2/10 and we're trying to add it to 43 hundredths. And we know that we cannot add when we have unlike denominators unless we make them equivalent fractions. So let's go ahead and take 2/10. And I know 10 times 10 equals 100. And if I do the multiplication to the denominator, I also have to do the multiplication to the numerator. So let's do 2 times 10, and that's gonna give me 20. So I know that 20/10 is an equivalent fraction to 2/10. And now I can add, and if I take 20/100 and I add it to 43 hundredths, I'm going to get 63 hundredths. That makes sense? Take a look at this next practice problem. We're looking at 17/100 and we are adding 6/10 to 17/100. Does it work the same way? Well, yeah, I still have two denominators that are different, and I still have to create an equivalent fraction so that both denominators become the same. So I'm going to take 10 and multiply it by 10, and that's going to give me 100. And if I do it to the denominator, I'm going to multiply to the numerator. So I'm going to do 10 times 6, and that's going to give me 60. So 6/10 is the exact same or equivalent fraction as 60 1/100. Think of it as dimes and pennies. 6/10 is the same as 6 dimes, which is 60 cents, and 60 pennies is the same as 60 cents. So they're equivalent fractions, right? So now all I need to do is add 17 plus 60. And when I add 17 to 60, I get 77 100s. So two more to go, and then I think you've got this down. Let's take a look at 2/10, and let's see how can we add that to 43/100. Again, cannot add denominators. Denominators have to be the same, and they stay the same all the way through addition, right? So let's find an equivalent fraction. Let's look at 2/10, because I know 10 is a multiple of 100. Let's do 10 times 10. That gives me 100. Well, I know what I do to the denominator. I have to do the numerator. So let's do 2 times 10, which gives me 20. So 2/10 is the same as 20/100. And now I can add 20 plus 43. And 20 plus 43 is the same as 63. And remember, that denominator stays the same. So 63/100. Let's take a look at 9/100 and let's add it to 9/10. And again, those denominators are not the same. I have to create an equivalent fraction with one of the fractions to make it the same. So let's use the 10, right? 10 times 10 equals 100. And if I do it to the denominator, I'm going to do it to the numerator. So I'm going to do 9 times 10, and that's going to give me 90. So 90/100 is the same as, or an equivalent fraction for, 9/10. And so now I can add 9 plus 90, and I know that the answer will now be 99/100. I think you did a great job of going through this tutorial with me, and I look forward to seeing how well you do on your practice paper. Good luck.